It's a Russian affair in Bratislava for the European Figure Skating Championships. Reigning Grand Prix champ Evgenia Medvedeva shocked the world in her first season as a senior and looks to top the podium in the Slovak Republic. 2015 European silver medalist Elena Radionova took home the bronze at the Grand Prix Finals and hopes to be part of back-to-back podium sweeps by Russia. 2015 European bronze medalist Anna Pogorelia failed to podium at her Grand Prix events this season, but looks to recapture the magic in Bratislava.
Easily number one.
That was beautiful.
That was inspirational. That was everything that a figure skating performer should
be. Right now, I was on the edge of my seat.
NBC Sports presents the European Figure Skating Championships from Bratislava, Slovakia. Today, we're on the Andrej Nepala Arena for the ladies' short program. Bill Seward alongside 2011 U.S. national champion Ryan Bradley. And a look at the start list. The final warm-up, Elena Radionova leading off, and then the teammates going 3 and 5. And as you mentioned so many times, the skate order critical, Ryan.
And it could be really crucial if Radionova delivers a big score early in that warm-up before Medvedeva even gets on. She could take her out of the event.
And one of their teammates that is not in attendance, the defending champ, not defending. Liza Tuktomasheva, she didn't qualify for this one.
Last season was her breakthrough year. She was the European champion, the world champion, and she came out this year, didn't look prepared early in the season, and when you're throwing a triple axel out, your margin for error all of a sudden can drop you to the bottom of the event.
Ready for our first competitor, and it is 21-year-old Natalie Winzerl, the 2014 German national champion and finished 12th in this event last year.
She's certainly going to hope to move up the ranks. 12th place wasn't a real satisfying placement, and there's a lot of opportunity as long as she goes out and gets through her elements at the beginning of the program.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by.
Opening with a very nice double axel to get her feet underneath her.
It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me.
Triple toe, double toe combination. Hoping for the triple triple there, but couldn't quite get her feet underneath her in time.
Of age and still with Olympic experience, 18 at Sochi.
Triple Lux that's in the second half of the program, garnering that 10% bonus.
I'm feeling good.
mentioned, 12th last year, 8th in 2014. Natalie Vinzel.
He's certainly going to be happy with this skate, but if you want to put pressure on those Russian girls, the importance of getting the triple-triple out, you want to maximize your points on all three jumping boxes. And as we take a look at this triple-toe combination, it got a little away from her. You could see the left arm behind her as she went to take off for the first toe. So she was a little back, put the toe pick in, and could only get two revolutions.
57.36, her best short program came at the World Championships in 2014, a 60.82. Vinzero gets it started.
And is currently in the first place. Okay, representing Sweden.
And that brings out from Sweden, 22-year-old Yoshi Helgeson.
And it was at this event last year that she really started her breakthrough. She had a great skate. She nearly made the podium, which obviously is so difficult with these Russian women. Take a review on that landing. Triple toe. Little slow on the landing, forcing her to do the double toe on the end of the combination.
Two-time Swedish national champion in 2013 and 2015.
To round out the jumping passes.
Of Sweden.
Certainly a performance that relies on the triple-triple when you're trying to make that push. Fourth place last year, trying to get on the podium, you need every single point. And the triple-double could really cost her. And it'll also come down to the second look at this triple Lutz. You can see as she comes down, there's a lot of spray of the snow. When the judges see that, they think that there's trouble coming off of that toe pick. And now here's a look. More spray again on the landing of the triple toe. She has the wherewithal to get her hands up, try to raise the grade of execution on the double toe. But that needs to be a triple toe for her to stay competitive.
I took notes from you, Coach, and you said, hey, the jumping passes, they're all great. The jumps are great, but it's the landings that lock them out and get you the points, and that's important. You see 58-13, Yoshi Helgason currently in the top spot. The final warm-up group will be hitting the ice when we come back. This event has been licensed by the International Skating Union, Lausanne, Switzerland, for this exclusive broadcast. All worldwide rights to this event expressly reserved to the International Skating Union. Unauthorized reproduction and use of this event is strictly prohibited. And the warm-up's on for this group and 16-year-old Elena Radionova. Well, was 16 years of age last year as the runner-up, and what a difference a year makes, Ryan.
And she's taken on a lot of steps to not only grow as a skater, but her maturity on the ice is far superior to last season.
Nicole Rajkova, the home favorite, of course, got to be a boost.
It's always exciting to skate in front of the home crowd. She has the elements, but it's the lines and the finish that'll keep her out of the top three.
And, of course, Evgenia Medvedeva, the Grand Prix final champion, so good in the juniors, and why not be so good in the seniors, too?
Well, she stepped up to the plate like she was the favorite in junior. She's in the seniors, and she's skating the exact same way. She's very smart about backloading her programs and getting a lot of jumping passes in the bonus.
And you see the feet on the junior side, and then the Russian senior champion this year. Angelina Kuzmowska, the 17-year-old Latvian, seventh last year. And, well, she's chatting with Coach. You're a coach. How much can you say here this late in the warm-ups?
It's all about just getting their head in the game, making sure they're focused on the details, staying calm, and trying to instill that confidence in the skaters so they can go out and deliver what they've been training.
There is 17-year-old Russian Anna Pogorelaya last year. She was third, and quite a roller coaster season for her now.
She had such a disaster at NHK this year that it's so important for her to right the ship, and the Russian Nationals was a step in the right direction.
And Roberta Ruggiero, the 25-year-old Italian, the veteran of the field, and one of her teammates certainly not here, but her chance to step up.
With Carolina Costner out these past couple of years, it's so important for Ruggiero to step up, keep Italian skating in the forefront.
Counting down to it, and Elena Radionova, runner-up last year. Can she take the first big step toward a title in the Europeans? 17-year-old Elena Radionova of Russia.
Representing Russia.
Second in this event last year. Bronze in the World Championships in 2015. And the Russian national champ from last year. And we said, what a difference a year makes in terms of perspective, an athlete going into something like this.
And she's really handled it well. She's not trying to do cutesy programs that she did last year. She's taken a mature step, and she's always such an exciting performer that it's really translated nicely. Strategy opening up with the triple-triple, trying to get that momentum right off the bat. Triple Lutz, triple toe, little close to the wall, so she had to pull the landing. No major mistake.
Two-time junior world champion.
Footwork, triple flip, very nicely executed. She has entered the bonus, getting that extra 10%. Right into the double axel, a little bit slow, but completed.
Feeling good about the effort, Elena Radionova, last year at the European Championships in the short program, led the way before a runner-up spot overall. When we talk about you got to avoid disaster and big mistakes, certainly in the short program, and she seemed pretty smooth through hers.
Especially skating this early, because if you make a big mistake in your run-through this far in the at the beginning of the group, you can really get a lower score as the later girls kind of pile on the points. But you see her strategy here, doing the triple lutz, triple toe, right at the beginning of the program. And you'll notice that'll be the biggest difference between Radionova and Medvedeva, who has all three of her jumping passes in the second half of the program, really trying to utilize that bonus. So it becomes so important for Radionova to hit these things and to hit them well, trying to get as many points on the grade of execution as she can to try to really stockpile those points before anyone else has stepped on the ice.
And you see 70-96, even better than last year when she led the way on the short program. You mentioned some get rid of the three jumping passes, almost try to get rid of them early and then coast home, while the others, they a little more dramatic, a little more of a crescendo to the finish of their program.
Well, the way the scoring system is based, they try to give you that bonus when you're trying to jump fatigued. But some skaters take advantage of it, and they do easy elements at the beginning so that they're still rested and getting that bonus. So we might see something change in the rules at some point, but until then, they're putting up huge numbers.
And the fans are picking it up on this one. Here is a home favorite, Nicole Rajkova, three-time Slovak national champion.
Thank you.
triple X, double loop combination.
Some credit though, not taking it all the way off the path.
That's such a huge thing in our sport, is when you get to that point where you're off your feet, trying to stay on your feet, not breaking the program, is such an important skill to keep you in the game. Jumping past the double axel late in the program.
Raskova, 11th last year in this event.
Obviously, the mistake on the triple loop could come back to haunt her. But when she's trying to improve upon last year's performance, she stayed on her feet. She got through the jump combination. She garnered some great points early in the program. So even with the mistake, she's sitting in a good position to try to grow on last year's. But if she's trying to make a push for that podium, the importance of the triple-triple, getting a double-loop combination is very difficult and very impressive, but it's not worth as many points as throwing, say, a triple toe on the end of the jump. So now when the solo jump comes up, you see her go up, it looks pretty good, doesn't quite get the free leg out quick enough, and you see her weight tumble to the outside. If you don't stop that rotation the moment you get down on the ice, that's just a lot of force that gets harder and harder to control, and then you're forced to put the free foot down.
Her best short program, the World Juniors in 2015, a 57-15, so it's better than she's done before, and she's in the fifth spot at the moment at the European Figure Skating Championships. Still ahead, Yevgenia Medvedeva, the 2016 Russian national champion. Gotta bring it out onto the ice at Bratislava. Special moment on ice, the reigning Grand Prix final champion, 16-year-old Yevgenia Medvedeva, the 2015 World Junior Champ and Junior Grand Prix final champ.
She's had such an impressive start to her senior career, and it's so important to look at her conditioning and the strength to be able to do these jumping passes late.
in the bonus. Triple flip, triple toe. Very nicely executed. Right into the double axe, a little wild into the outside. Has to turn forward and put that foot down. Right back on track with a beautiful triple loop out of footwork.
And as you mentioned, it's nice to be able to do it when you're in that bonus situation.
Just understanding the scoring system and taking advantage of it the best way you can.
Yevgenia Medvedeva, the 16-year-old, was the Russian junior national champion last year and just stepped right into the spot on the senior circuit to take the national championship this year.
I love that she just comes out and does her job. She knows that she can get through these jumping passes. She knows how difficult they are, but doesn't change her rhythm. She doesn't change her speed. She just stays aggressive all the way through these passes. She loves to rotate with that arm over the head, and that gives you points on the grade of execution. And now she's tacking on grade of execution with that 10% bonus. Now, we saw the little trouble on the double axel, and we don't see mistakes from her very often, but when we do, they tend to be on that double axel. It's a little bit more difficult of a forward edge takeoff, trying to control that, but you can see the strength in her triples, getting right back on the horse with that triple loop. So important to be able to follow up a mistake with a nice, well-landed element.
Extremely impressive how such a lithe little athlete, per se, can generate so much power going into those spins.
And she can do it so consistently, which is so impressive.
And a pretty decent point total at 72.55 vaults her into the top spot at the moment. Yevgenia Medvedeva, the reigning Grand Prix final champ and Russian national champion.
And it's a good score. I'm sure she would probably like more points than that. But it's going to be good enough to put her in that top spot, and I doubt there's anybody that can touch that number in this event.
Angelina Kozbaska, a 17-year-old from Latvia, will give it a go. Seventh last year in this event. And returns. Had some injuries earlier in the career. An ankle injury in the summer of 2015. Angelina Kozbaska.
Jumping passes. This is a very old school way of looking at the short program, but if the skater is comfortable, you've got to do what they can do to do a completely clean program.
How do the judges see something like that? Do they want to see you balance it out a little more or no?
The theory is you want there to be a balance, the jumps on different sides of the rink in different places in the program. But when it comes to the technical score, you've got to do the most to maximize that number in the upper left-hand corner. And hitting that bonus is the way you do that.
Angelina Kuzmowska, two-time national champion of Latvia, seventh in this event last year, and putting in her performance. We will take a look at her scores and have much more on the other side of a quick timeout. Angelina Kuzmowska. Let's take a look at her program.
Now, she opened up with such a nice triple lutz. And when you do the solo jump before the triple-triple, the importance of being able to not only land it, but land it with speed and flow to give you confidence so that as she does this triple toe, reaches back, powers through for the triple toe. You can see her weight getting a little forward, but because of the earlier jumping pass, she had the confidence, she knew her legs were underneath her, and she knew that she was finding that axis, which is such an important thing. And as we see sometimes when skaters get to the outside, it's hard to get back on.
And a 58.99 for her moves her into third position. She's probably got to feel okay about that because last year in the short program, a 49.28. She was in 17th position after the short program, wound up seventh. Really put it together in the free skate. Angelina Kuzmowska.
And you certainly want to be in that higher place in the short program. It just makes your job going into that long program that much easier.
And the third of our Russian troika, Anna Pogorelai. Third last year. Gets the pat on the back, and then guess what? It's all yours.
And out of these Russian girls, she's the one that isn't as consistent. We've seen it time and time again where all the girls will go out, hit their big tricks, and Pogorelai will randomly have little slips on the double axel and the easier triples. Beautiful combination to start this off. So where triple loop becomes the double. Now it is a requirement to do a triple jump out of footwork. So with the double loop, she does not meet that requirement, so she will get 0 points for that box.
That could be huge after watching your teammates go before you, both of them posting in the 70s on their scores.
But much better on the double axel. So important to get those mistakes out of your head.
And a reminder, of course, to some of the non-veterans, the real-time estimate of the judges' technical scores there in those purple boxes. The leader on top. Program a 72-26. She would need that to move into second. And as you mentioned, Ryan, with a big void in part of the program, probably not going to get there. We will tabulate her score and see the final skater when the European Figure Skating Championships continue after this. Anna Pogorelia was the third of the Russian teammates to go, and third might be where she lands, as missing a part of an element there in her short program.
Missing an entire element, she's going to hope to hold on to third. Obviously, she got a lot of points on that opening triple Lutz triple toe, but when that triple loop becomes a double loop and doesn't meet the requirement, she's really leaving a lot of points on the table, because you not only lose the element, you lose the extra points from grade of execution. The judges take a look and realize that this skater has seven elements and only met six of the requirements. So that could really drop the score. But that being said, her energy and performance at the end of the program stayed at a very high level.
63-81 puts her behind Radyanova at 70-96 in second, and Medvedeva in the top spot at 72-55.
You have to think those other girls in the 70s are untouchable, but 63 points in this event is not an untouchable number. So if one of these girls, well, Redigiero, puts everything out there, she could hope to really take a stab at that number.
And here is Roberta, the 25-year-old from Italy. Eighth last year.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
Has some familiarity, certainly, with the arena.
Representing Russia,
the Andre Nepala 2014
Italy,
champion.
And there is something to be said about going out, even at an easier competition, in a venue. When you have good skates in a venue, going back into that arena feels much more comfortable and familiar. Executed to start this program off. Footwork triple flip with just a flawless landing.
familiar setting for her, and the addition of she's essentially carrying the torch for Italy.
And that's a ton of pressure, especially with all the success that Carolina Costner brought for Italian skating. So trying to live up to that is a lot, but she's definitely upped her game in the absence.
In the short program last year with a 51-79. Got a shot at being on the podium, at least for the short program side.
Well, you've got to think, 63 points is a pretty big number. But the way that she just delivered, and we look at her technical score in the upper left-hand corner, that's ahead of Pogo Relia right now. But as she got through these jumping passes, the triple toe, watch the spine as she exits the air. She stays upright. You don't see spray off of the toe pick. All of her landings were so well executed that that's why her technical score puts her ahead of Pogo Relia. Now it will come down to the judges and those program components to see where they slotted her skating skills, her performance and interpretation and such as. But that will really come down to them. She did her job.
And a 61-01, so into fourth position. Seems to be okay with that. And in that four spot, chasing once again the three Russians, Medvedeva, Radyanova, Pogo Relia, and really, Ryan, in the 70s, those top two could be just the a 1-2 battle. I know you never say never, but stranger things have happened. The short program completed. They'll move on to the free. For Ryan Bradley, I'm Bill Seward. Thanks for joining us.